Welcome, Bucs fans, to Pewter Report's Week 14 Film Room. We're going to be looking at Tom Brady today and some of his best and worst moments from this game against the Bills. It was really a mixed bag performance from him, and that is very unusual in and of itself. So I thought it was a performance that looked that we should maybe look at it a little bit closer and see if there's any potential issues here and how he rectified some issues as the game went on. I'm Jon Ledyard, by the way, from pewterreport.com. You can check out the Pewter Report film rooms. Over the last couple of weeks, we've had All-22 film rooms going up. I know Paul Atwall, also of pewterreport.com, is going to have some more going up this week. So if you like this video, please hit like, hit the thumbs up button on this YouTube video, and send it to somebody. Send it to somebody you know and that you think would appreciate some more Bucs content in their life, or some Tom Brady content in their life. We greatly appreciate that, as always. Subscribe as well to the Pewter Report TV on YouTube. Okay, here's Brady in the first touchdown pass of the game. We're going to show a couple good plays at first, then we'll show a couple plays where he messed up, and then we'll come back to the end of the game scenario, how a couple plays can change the perception of a lot of different things, and how he made the Bills pay in overtime. All right, here we've got, let's move this over to the side here, but here we've got the Bucs. I believe this is third down. Yeah, after Leonard Fournette dropped the first down on second down, he dropped a new set of downs. Brady's back to pass here. Now he sees this game coming here, and he actually wants to throw this ball to Evans the whole time. Evans on that corner route, he's reading out that concept, and he realizes when he gets out here, so he's giving himself a better platform to throw it from, because he knows he's going to have to step into this one to get it there with the velocity that he does. And the Bucs actually don't do a terrific job of picking up this game. They're in position if Brady would have been in the pocket here, but because he's outside here, he actually, a rare instance where Brady actually kind of invites the pressure, but he knows he's doing it. He's not doing it blindly. He knows he's doing it to set up this throw. This is why he's doing it. So he does it because he knows he's got to get to this spot and rip it. He knows he's going to take a shot and, you know, he's going to get hit at least. And he actually doesn't, he gets the throw off before he actually gets hit too much. So, but this is just an absolute frozen rope to Mike Evans in the back corner of the end zone, right over the safety's hand. And that's one of the best safeties in the league. And he sees the coverage the whole way. He knows what he's up against with this throw. This is not like him last desperation throw. You can see he's looking at this the whole way. He knows what's out there, and he's just going to lace this thing to Evans. And this is put kind of back shoulder, actually. Hyde's trying to undercut it. So if he throws it out here, the safety's actually going to have a chance to make a play on this ball. But because he throws it and makes Evans kind of turn and go back for it and go up and back for it, he actually puts in a spot where the safety, he kind of puts it behind the safety a little bit so Evans can come down with it. Again, the velocity in the throw, obviously the catch is phenomenal, but it's pretty special stuff there. And later in the game, you probably have, again, these are probably two of his best throws of the year, to be honest. And later in the game, you have, I think it was maybe the next drive or so, you have this play where Giovanni Bernard actually kind of picks this up pretty well. But again, Brady kind of slides. He knows what he wants to do with his ball. He knows that the pressure's coming from here. Giovanni Bernard blocks him. If Brady is here in the pocket, this is a pretty good block by Giovanni Bernard. You know, he thinks that Brady's probably going to be over here somewhere. By the way, you can see Ryan Jensen absolutely just murdering a man, ending his life. This was all game with Ryan Jensen and Ed Oliver over here. But Brady, he slides over here because, again, he knows what he wants to do, and he knows he might take a shot, and he does. He actually gets knocked down on this play, but he's throwing this one. He knows where he wants to go with the ball the whole time. Again, he's going to Evans. Just a little rainbow shot right to him on the sideline. I mean, just the placement on this throw, the timing, like, to get it there right as Evans reached the sideline before the defensive back could get there. It's just an unreal throw, right? So it looks like it's going to be one of those crazy days for Brady, right? Just a straight heater day, you know, heat check throws all game long. But then there are some lulls in the middle of this game that are very curious because they're clean platform throws, and you never see Brady make these mistakes. And here's a play action one. And note Chris Godwin right here in the slot. He's going to run this over route here, and he's going to be wide open. Bills blow the coverage. He's going to be wide open on it. Looks like cover three from the Bills. The deep safety's here, and this post pattern kind of takes the deep safety. And so these linebackers are dropping out, but nobody, this route by Fournette is basically like flare control route. It's going to control Poyer, the safety here, I believe, to keep him from dropping out underneath this route. So Brady knows that he's got something right off the bat. He knows where he's going with this ball. He's just waiting for Godwin to get through the layers, and it's a little longer developing. He's got a clean pocket. He's got tons of space to throw this ball from. And he just throws it way too low. I mean, if he hits Godwin standing up, It's a catch and run opportunity with two guys to beat and a blocker out here. I mean, this could be a touchdown on a blown coverage like this. And so, yeah, he if this ball's up higher, which Brady, I mean, you just never see him miss a throw low over the middle like that unless he's trying to intentionally put it low. And there's just no reason to kind of put that throw low. And so we'll get to another miss in a second here. But this is just one of those things that I just never see Brady make this mistake. And so he throws it low. Godwin makes this sliding catch. It's not really that tough of a catch. It's just, you know, it's just, man, this could be a big run after catch opportunity. Gets him maybe 3 yards after the catch. Then here's the after the Richard Sherman interception, I believe. Brady's back to pass on this possession. And again, clean pocket, no pressure. Had barely gotten hit all day. And this one's just behind Gronkowski down the seam. And I thought, Paul and I thought maybe on the live show this was intentional, like a miscommunication. He thought Gronkowski was a stop, and maybe it is. I'm just not sure why he expects that. Like this, there's no pressure. Gronkowski's wide open from the very beginning. They have a route out here with Fournette out in the flat that is opening this up, that's taking Milano out of the picture here. And so he knows Gronkowski's wide open. This is exactly the concept he's looking for. Gronkowski's just kind of waiting for the ball. This linebacker's never going to make a play. There's just nobody else to worry about here, so why not just put the ball on him? It's not like he's running full speed and then tries to come back for this. He's slowed down. You know, this should be an easy, just hit him right where he's standing type of throw, and Brady puts it on his back hip, and it's incomplete, and they ended up, that would have been in field goal range and would have been 3 points right there. So big moment in the game for sure that Brady just missed him. And then here's Brady later in the game. This is another throw. This is the next possession, actually, I believe. I think that third miss to Godwin might have been first possession of the third quarter. Here's second possession of the third quarter. This is third down again. Super clean pocket. Great throwing lane. Exactly what he wants. Receivers, Chris Godwin, wide open in the middle of the field. And Brady just puts it low. I mean, you could see the mechanics. I think this, I would say, I'm not a mechanics expert, but I think this leg gets a little out of control for Brady as he throws this one and loses some, and the ball kind of dips on him. Maybe the release point's a little low. I don't know all of the details, but this dig route is wide open for Godwin in the middle of the field. I mean, nobody's covering him at all, and they can't complete it because it's too low, and they miss out on a third down opportunity there early in the game. So these opportunities ended up mounting, obviously, and the Bills end up coming back in this game. And they did miss. They did have some other issues too. You know, there were some play calling things. Maybe Paul will talk about those in another video. But I want to point out this end of game situation here. Okay, this is a 2nd and 6 for the Bucs. This is with 3.5 minutes or so left in the game. A first down here probably, it makes the Bills burn all their timeouts for sure before they get the ball back. And so this would make it very tough for the Bills if they are able to get anything in this situation. So you can see Brady play action. They got the call they want, gets the safety. The Bills are run blitzing. They think the Bucs are going to try and run some clock. Brady gets out. This is a tough throw, very tough throw. Brady on the move, throwing deep. Not really something the Bucs have done all season. It's just an interesting play call. I mean, Chris Godwin is the only route on this side of the field. I don't love this play call, but really, it still should have worked. Despite you can question the process, but it still should have worked. You watch Godwin here. He gets completely grabbed and held. But I mean, this is a pretty egregious holding all the way through the route. Actually turns Godwin's whole body. He's trying to get vertical, turns his whole body toward the numbers, and then he can't get vertical again. So really an egregious defensive hold here that goes uncalled in a key situation of the game, and the throw is just off as a result of that penalty. So, you know, PFF probably docks Brady for this because they don't get into penalties. But to my opinion, that's a flaw in their process because this is clearly a hold. This is clearly a defensive penalty, and it throws off the throw. So again, little things can change the perception. Brady missed another deep shot. Not really. That one was not on him, in my opinion. Here's the next play, 3rd and 6. Brady makes what would be one of the probably the play of the game, but an egregiously bad holding penalty on Donovan Smith is called that wipes out this play. This is 3rd and 6 with like 3 minutes left in the game, and Brady's got an opportunity to win this thing for them here, or not win it, but put it in doubt. I mean, this is going to be tough for the Bills if they can convert this. He's back to pass here in this situation. And by the way, that Godwin completion stopped the clock. So even if they call a penalty there, it's a new set of downs for the Bucs. If they can complete it there, then obviously then they're in field goal range pretty soon after that. So here's Brady back to pass. Pressure's coming. He wants this concept over here. Again, Milano gets called for a hold for the Bills here. You can see he's got his hands around Fournette's neck. So he's got the penalty here that should happen as Milano grabs Fournette on his release. doesn't let him out. So Brady can't throw it to him because of that. And he can't throw here. There's also a hold happening here. I don't know which, I don't think they called this one, but there's a hold happening here as well. But so Brady can't throw to either of these options, right? They're not open. So he, you know, gets some contact here, gets a hand around his face there and gets out of the pocket and throws to Chris Godwin, improvises, gets the first down. Now, this is a great play by Brady, right? Just the presence of mind, the way to stay alive, concept isn't there at first. And there's, you know, Alex Kappa's getting bull rushed toward him, gets hit here a little bit by two players, once in the face. I hate those penalties, so I'm not wishing they would have called it, but just pointing it out. And keeps his awareness, throws to Godwin for the first down, okay? Good stuff. This is what they called on Donovan Smith. They called this a hold on Donovan Smith. Watch this block. This is not a hold. This is a pancake. He destroys this guy. At no point is this player's jersey away from his body, or is this a hold? That is a completely dominant block. And they hit him on a penalty for it, offsetting penalties instead of just being against the Bills or just being a first down for the Bucs. If there were no call, instead it's back to 3rd and 6 and the Bucs don't get it. Brady got sacked by Matt Milano. They missed him blitzing as a green dog off the edge. And so that was the situation where obviously the officiating worked against the Bucs twice in a row. I know Bills fans are griping about it. I'm not griping about it so much as I'm just pointing out these things happen in a game, and they would have changed the perception if the Bills had won, because Bills get the ball, Bills come back, tied 27, all of a sudden it's Brady's second half failures. Well, Brady actually made plays in both those situations, and despite concepts not really being there that much or not being that great on the Godwin deep shot, and instead the perception would have changed had the Bills been able to emerge victorious when the onus should have been on the officials probably. Here's the overtime play, though. Brady comes back from all those mistakes, ends up making the play in overtime here, and here's what he's reading out. We've already seen this play broken down probably everywhere, but Brady's taking this snap, going back to pass, a mesh concept right here. You've got Mike Evans coming across the field over the top, and you've got Breshad Perryman coming underneath, hoping to get some sort of a rub, but actually Evans beats Dane Jackson so badly here that Dane Jackson's kind of already fallen off the route, so he's already lost kind of here. But it doesn't matter for Evans because they're picking him up. This corner over here that was on Perryman, it was man coverage. By the way, the little motion from Godwin showed you man as they shifted here. Okay, now he's got Godwin. So Brady sees that it's probably man, checks it after the snap. It is man. You can see the man turn from these corners. But they're passing it off in this man. They're making a call to pass this off. So this corner's going to take Evans. This corner should take Perryman, Dane Jackson. Remember, he's in because Tre'Davious White's injury. He should take Perryman in this situation. He doesn't. Tremaine Edmonds is alert and recognizes the situation, but this is a 4-2 wide receiver, and Edmonds is a fast linebacker, but this is a 4-2 wide receiver. And so good luck. Brady gets backside on this progression. You can see him looking for Evans here, reading out these, looking for Gronkowski here, looking at this three-man concept to this side, and Perryman is kind of on the backside of this thing. Brady recognizes that both DBs go with Evans. He hits Perryman in stride, and he's off and running. And Tremaine Edmonds, like I said, fast linebacker, but not many guys going to catch Breshad Perryman in the open field. There's one thing we can definitely say about him. Joe Tryon-Chuenko running down the sideline wants to be the first guy there to congratulate him when he scores. And so pretty cool stuff. But again, Brady just sticking with it. Protection is great too. Bills run like a little blitz here, and they kind of try to twist. They kind of get Milano coming off the edge free, and Tristan Wirfs just makes an unreal play because Fournette doesn't really recognize it. He thinks Milano's coming inside, so he steps inside, but instead the DN twists inside and Milano wraps. Watch Tristan Wirfs, like, in a horrible position, gets out and gets a one-handed shove while Leonard Fournette is tripping him to knock down Matt Milano. Just an unreal play here by Wirfs to save Brady from at least getting a hit. I don't know if they would have got a sack or affected the throw, but and Brady makes the rest happen. So it was a weird day for the Bucs quarterback. He wasn't as good as maybe the raw numbers indicate, but it wasn't as bad as like PFF's grade indicates either. So lots of good. The accuracy stuff has not been a concern all year, but there are a couple throws here and there where you're like, okay, you'd like to see Brady be a little bit better in those situations. So keep an eye on it moving forward, but more than anything, just continue to be amazed at how this guy does it with the arm strength and the movement in the pocket and the velocity on throws and the timing and the ability to get through progressions. Pretty special stuff from the quarterback position, and the Bucs are getting some great quarterback play this season from Tom Brady, who should be the MVP right now. So Appreciate y'all tuning in. Again, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit the like button on this YouTube video, share it with somebody, subscribe to Pewter Report TV, help us out in those ways. We greatly appreciate it. And look for more film rooms coming soon to you at Pewter Report TV. Thanks so much for listening, everybody.